Hello, today we will discuss about another technique for finding good lower bound to minimization problem, which is called Lagrangian relaxation. Okay, you can view this technique as an alternative technique to linear programming. And we will apply this technique to a specific problem, which is the constraint shortest path problem that I will explain now. So in this problem, we want to find the shortest path from node 1 to node 6 in a graph, which is represented here. Of course, we want to minimize the total distance, which is represented by the first component of every couple that you see here. This is the distance of the edge. But you also have here another value, which is the resource that you will consume. It might be, for instance, the amount of fuel or the total elevation that you want to do during a path on a map or something like that. It might be another resource in general. And this resource that you will consume also by going through the path is limited here up to T. Okay, this is why it's called the constraint shortest path problem. Okay, without this resource constraint, it will be a very standard shortest path problem. But because of that constraint, the problem is difficult to solve and it's NP hard. Okay, that's the problem. We can formulate this problem as an integer linear program like this. You will introduce one binary variable for every edge, okay, and every such variable can take the value 0 or 1 to say that you select or do not select the edge, okay. And so what you want to minimize is the total cost of the edges that you will select inside the final solution, and you don't want to consume more resource that is allowed, so up to T, okay, and this will be the TIP values that you will use here, okay. So this, the TIP is the second coordinate that you will find on every pair of values on the edge, and the first one is the cost of the edge. But of course, you need additional constraints, and the additional constraint that you will add is what I call the flow conservation constraints. Okay, the flow conservation constraint means, for instance, that you want to have at exactly one unit of flow going out of node 1, because this is the one you are starting from. So you will write that the sum over all the edges j going out of node 1 is equal to 1. And of course, you have the same for the node 6, which is the node that you need to reach. And you will write that the summation over, so this was the one going out, okay? And so here you will say the one that are incoming to this node 6, okay, that are incoming to this node 6, xj6, are also equal to 1. You want exactly one unit of flow going into the node 6. And for the other nodes, for instance, this one, the node 3, you will have something like that. You will say that for every node I, okay, that does not belong to 1 or 6, okay, which is different from 1 or 6, you have that the amount of flow that is incoming inside the node is equal to the amount of flow that is going out, and which it should be exactly equal to 1. So you want to have for the other ones that the amount of flow, okay, so for every j going out of the node I, okay, and so you will write x going out, so you will go here. Okay, so the total amount of flow, sorry, is equal to the amount of flow inside this one, so xij. Okay, so these are what we call the flow conservation constraints. Okay, it makes sure that you have a valid path. I do not write them, so in the next slides I will always write it like this, flow conservation constraint. But what I mean is exactly this is the flow conservation constraint inside the linear program. So this is the constraint shortest path problem that we want to solve, and because of this additional resource constraint here, the problem is NP-hard. So, in the next slides, I will use the following notation. C of P for a given path P, okay? And a path is will be, sorry, a path will be denoted like the set of vertices that I need to visit. So the path P 1, 2, 4, 6 means 1, 2, 4, 6. This is the one that is represented in bold here. And I will use the notation CP to denote its cost, and TP to denote the amount of time. So this is a summation of the second coordinates. So if you take this one, 1, 2, 4, 6, I will add 1. Okay, this 3. And this is why the cost is equal to 3. And if you take the total time, okay, it will be 10 plus 1 plus 7, which is 18 here. Okay, this is the amount of time. And this is the one that is restricted by capital T, which is the capacity of the resource. This is an example of a feasible solution, for instance, assuming that T is equal to 10 here. Okay, assuming that T is equal to 10, the path that we have represented before is not valid anymore. And one possible solution is this one. Okay, 1, 3, 5, 6 is one valid solution, because you see that 3 plus 3 plus 2 is equal to 8, which is less than T, which is the maximum value that is allowed by the total time. Okay, so this is one feasible solution, but not all of them are feasible, right? If you take this one, it was not feasible, because you would have 10 plus 1 plus 7, which is 18, and so this one, okay, is not allowed here because of the capacity of the resource.